How to do modeling with polygon primitives in Maya. By the end of this lesson, you will learn how to create this basic polygon primitive based bicycle very easily in a very short span of time. Let's start learning how to create this model. Go to create menu, polygon primitives, and this tier of this menu as we are using again and again. With these polygon primitives, we are going to create a bicycle. This is what we are going to create. Having this basic diagram, you can search from online, like a bicycle icon, that is what I searched. I got it. And we are going to start. First, we'll create the wheels. That is torus. Remove the interactive creation. Torus. We always use three things here mainly. One is move. Second one is rotate. WER, move, rotate, and scale, along with the parameters of the objects, polygon primitive parameters. We want to rotate this and even channel box. In the previous section, we have explained all these things very clearly. What are the transformations, how to do about channel box, about the history and parameters, polygon primitives, user interface, everything explained. So in this lesson, we are not going to cover all those basic things. Our focus is modeling. If you have not watched the previous sections, please watch the previous sections before proceeding further. If you are viewing this on YouTube, you please visit our website simplyinfo.net. Even this course link is provided below in the description. I'm increasing the radius. See, this looks like not smooth, so we need to increase the parameters. Even I want to increase the subdivisions in this one. Maximum is 50. Still, if you want more, make it, enter the number from here. We'll make it 75. See, now it is looking smooth. If you want to go this much close, still you need to increase the resolution. But this is a good number. We'll decrease this way. I think 20 is good. Yeah, for me, this is in this distance we see, so that is looking good. I think minus 90 is better. Why I am doing minus 90 is actually it is coming like this. Okay, that is no problem. Select this. I'm using W. Control D is duplication. Right now, don't bother about the position and everything. Just create the model, and we created these two. Then I'm going to create this structure, this one and this one. Even we can keep that image as a reference image, but right now I'm not doing that. Go to cylinder and create. We want subdivisions. We want height. I'm clicking this and I'm holding middle mouse so that interactively you can decrease and increase. Just after selecting the property, using your mouse, middle mouse button. Oh, this looks good. We need to, as a beginner, you may feel little difficult in rotating. It may go like this, like this. Just use these numbers. If you are like that, just make it 0, for example. Make it 0. Then you will see in x-axis, make this 0. This comes out like that. we need in z axis. So this is what is the number, and move this. This is where tool settings comes. These are the polygon primitives, and these are object, because we want to scale it. If it is world axis, you will scale like this, it won't work. After rotating the object, if you want to scale, you need object mode, then we can scale it like this. This is very, very important. First get the basic shape, then we'll work on how to adjust, refine the model in the end. First we will make the cylinder. Create one more cylinder, and I will use even this, rotate 90 degrees. Yeah, this is what exactly we need. Control D, duplicate. We'll keep it in the center of this object. We will align them both. Even aligning explained in the previous section. First go to modify, align objects. And we want to select this first and select this last, because I'll use this last selected object, and align. See, that is aligned in all axes, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, everything. Got it? And even we need one more. This we created. Even we need this center, we'll duplicate this, and Control D, we'll keep it in the center. Something like this. That will be little bit down. Like this, even they are a little bit far away. Select all, see, when you are selecting, sometimes when you move, see, that is getting scaling, because one is in world mode. In the type of situations, right now we don't disturb this. We will try to disturb these two. So this is this distance is more than this. I'll duplicate this one more time. Control D is the shortcut for duplication. Zero. I'll make it this as zero. And then E is the shortcut for rotation. 90. W is the shortcut. Even little bit scale down. And little bit banding is there. That is what right now we don't bother whether it is going inside or not, just we want to get the shape. We are creating a 3D icon kind of thing. And then one more is required. Control D and rotate. I'll go a little bit faster. Yeah, it has to align to here. Scale down a little bit. and we need one more like this. Control D and rotate this way. That is parallel to this. These two are almost parallel. So here it is looking almost parallel. First we will create the horizontal one. degrees W, it has to be like this. The distance between them is very less, so maybe it is here. This is, we need one more like this. I'll duplicate this and rotate. Control D. Scale it down a little bit. See, I'm using three operations, transformations. We call them transformations. Move, rotate, scale. It has to fit here. Little bit bigger. Now the seat. This is a basic modeling with primitives. You don't forget that. I'll close the tool settings. Now go to, we need some sphere. We'll scale down. See that? Super. So it's very good. It's coming out nice. And we need one more like this. Control D, rotate this 90 degrees. When you are rotating, by this time you should understand that first I rotate, then I make the exact values. Generally we need 90s, 180s, 270s, like that. And I'm using object mode. That's the thing. If you keep it whirled, it's not possible to move in this direction. I'm using the object mode in the tool settings. You need to keep that in mind. See, we can move it this way. And Control D one more time. Now we need to move it in world space, because it goes like this. I don't want that. I want this to go in world space. Degrees. Move this, direction. Once one side is completed, then Control D, duplicate and drag this side. Very simple. See, we created with the just primitives and transformations, scaling, rotating, moving, and in tool settings we used object mode and world space mode and object space mode. I hope you liked this video. You can also create this kind of models very easily in just within 2-3 days of learning Maya. Even if you are a beginner, even if you know the basics, you can create very easily this kind of wonderful objects. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and also share on your Facebook and social media so that your friends may like this video and they also learn it freely.